In this lesson, you will learn how to create a table. No, I don't mean the kind that needs chairs. I mean the kind that arranges their data into rows and columns, like this. So let's talk about the tools you need to build your tables. You will use the HTML table element to define a table. If you want to define table rows, use tr elements. You'll need one tr element for each row. Each row consists of one or more td elements, also known as table data. These act as columns inside the table and define data for each table cell. You can also add headings for each column by using the th element. Phew, did you get all that? Let's do a quick recap. Define a table with the table element. Define rows with the tr elements. Add headings with the th elements. And add table data with td elements. Those are the basic tools you need to build HTML tables. By the way, you should note that table headings are bold and centered by default. And borders won't just appear automatically. So if you want a border on your table, you must specify it. Here's how. The CSS border property defines a border. As you can see in the result, this will display a table with double borders. If you don't want that, use the border collapse property to display a single table border. If you want to add a little extra padding to the cells, use the CSS padding property. If you want to change the alignment of text within the cell, use the CSS text align property. Now let's say you want a cell to span over many columns. For that, you have to use the colspan attribute. It should be added directly to the table cell, like this. Just like you would have to use the rowspan attribute to make a cell span over many rows. Well, there you have it. Now you know how to add tables to your website. Happy building!